the previous video, you've learned to export a project to images. Today, in this video, we will introduce you to another choice to export your project. That is exporting to video, which is considered as the best way to demonstrate to learners. First of all, you should shrink the project to reduce the project file size. It helps save time when exporting. See how to shrink to reduce project file size video for details. After selecting the video button, the export to video dialog will appear with two tabs. The general tab brings you four big groups of options: rendering options, video, audio, and output. At the rendering options section, the first three options are selected by default. It means that they will appear in the output video when inserted in the project. This option allows you to have a separate subtitle file. Thanks to that, you can edit the font size and color of the subtitle and change its language. Besides, you can have closed captions to be hard-coded inside the video if you tick this checkbox. However, you can't edit any attribute of closed captions anymore. You can also export your project to a video, then embed it in an HTML page to be viewed in a browser. Video size is equal to the project size. When you change this value, the height and width will be changed. Frame rate is the number of frames per second. The most commonly used range is about 20 to 30 frames per second. For example, the film industry usually uses 24 frames per second. The audio section lets you change the properties and quality of the audio file in the output video. Select either mono or stereo. If there is no special audio quality, the mono channel is good enough for recording video demonstrations. Sample rate is the number of samples of audio carried per second. The higher value brings you a better audio quality, but it will make the file size bigger. As you may know, when downloading a MP3 song from the internet, it offers you two options of bit rate: 128 kilobits per second and 320 kilobits per second. The audio having 320 kilobits per second is better for sure, but here, 128 kilobits per second is good enough. The output section allows you to change the format of the output video and the location where it will be saved. Now, turn to the Advanced tab. As you can see, this tab is disabled. To activate this tab, select Embedded in HTML at the General tab. You can have the thumbnail for the exported video by selecting a slide image from your project or an image from your file system. Let's see the output.
Wuzhen, one of the top 10 charming famous towns in China, has long history of over 1,300 years. Also, as one of the top 6 ancient towns in Jiangnan area. Wuzhen Water Town is your ideal place to savor the authentic features of a Jiangnan water.
Thanks for watching.